Hey Mountain Church, stoked to be doing a life group with you again this week. We're going to continue through our series on the Sermon on the Mount, which is really Jesus, the King of Kings, his teachings on the principles of the kingdom. We're going to pick up where we left off last time, which is Matthew chapter 7, verse 7. Jesus taught this: "Ask and it will be given to you. Seek and you'll find. Knock and it will be opened to you. For everyone who asks receives, and the one who seeks finds, and to the one who knocks it will be opened. Or which one of you, if his son asks him for bread, will give him a stone? Or if he asks for a fish, will give him a serpent? If you then, who are evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will your Father who is in heaven give good things to those who ask him? So, whatever you wish that others would do to you, do also to them, for this is the law and the prophets." Well, this passage of scripture, we're going to look at it two ways. One, as a standalone passage of scripture, and then also contextually, what is Jesus saying in the context of the verses before and the verses after? Now, standalone, this is a great, great passage of scripture, some of my favorite in the Word of God. Number one, it just talks about our heart of dependence with the Father. It talks about prayer, that we are to be in a relationship with our God, with the Father, that is totally dependent upon Him, that is asking and seeking and knocking. And the text, in the original language, it's ask and keep asking, seek and keep seeking, knock and keep knocking. And that one who is in a continual state of looking and asking and seeking and just being a focused and directed towards the Father, that is the individual, that is the Christian who receives from the Father. And our Father, our God in heaven, He's good. I have three kids, and if my son or my daughter, if they asked me for a piece of pizza, I wouldn't give them my shoe to chew on. If they asked me for a hamburger, I wouldn't tell them to go eat dirt. And I technically, apart from Christ, apart from redemption, I'm evil, I'm a sinner, I'm lost, apart from Christ. Now God is altogether holy. He is altogether pure. He is love. He is good. How much more will the Heavenly Father give to those kids, His kids, who are in a state of dependence? So number one, Jesus is talking about our relationship with the Father. Our vertical relationship with the Father, with God, is to be in a relationship of dependence. But secondly, He's talking about horizontally our relationship with humanity. We are to treat others as we would have them do unto us. This is known as the golden rule. Do unto them as you also would have them do unto you. This is the golden rule to live by, and really Jesus kind of sums up the whole law and the prophets, the Old Testament rules and regulations dealing with humanity. It's all kind of summed up in this: do unto others as you would have them do unto you. So with the Father, we're dependent. With others, we're living a life that is gracious, knowing that we're going to live and love others as we would have them love us, if you would. By itself, this is a great passage of Scripture. But notice that whenever you take a passage of Scripture, there are verses before and there are verses after. And anytime we want to look at the Word of God, it's important to understand that the context plus the content equals the meaning. So we have the content, what is the context, and that will really give us the meaning of what Jesus is talking about. In chapter 7, in verse 1, Jesus begins with, "Judge not, lest you be judged." He goes on to talk about how can you pull the speck of dust out of your brother's eye if you have a beam in your own eye. He goes on later on after this and talks about warning against false prophets, and he says, "You'll know a tree by its good fruit." The context of chapter 7 is dealing with judging others condemningly, which only God is the one that can judge, but also having discernment and being able to discern good and evil, right and wrong, a sheep from a wolf or a pig or a dog. So contextually, what is Jesus saying? Because it seems kind of out of place. The chapter is about judging and having discernment. And then in the middle of this, Jesus talks about prayer and doing unto others as you would have them do unto you. Well, I know for me, when I deal with people, when I walk and talk and live life with people, I need wisdom from God. I don't know if a person is a sheep or a wolf. I need discernment from the Father. How can I know if a person is a pig? I'm not supposed to cast my pearls before a swine. Well, how do I know a tree by its fruit? I need discernment, and I can only get that discernment by seeking and knocking and asking and being dependent upon the Father. The Bible says in James chapter 1, verse 5, if any of you lack wisdom, let him ask God, who gives generously to all without reproach, and it will be given him. Solomon prayed in 1 Kings chapter 3, verse 9. He prayed to God, give thy servant, therefore, an understanding heart to judge thy people, that I may discern between good and evil. For who is able to judge this thy great people? And James chapter 3, verse 17, James says this, but the wisdom from above is first pure, then peaceable, gentle, open to reason, full of mercy and good fruits, impartial and sincere. So we seek God so that we can have the Holy Spirit filling, giving us discernment, the Holy Spirit revealing to us how to live and how to love. And how can we do unto others unless we have the wisdom from God? So when we live this life, we're to be dependent upon the Lord. There are ravenous wolves that have sheep's clothing on and they want to tear apart the flock of God. There are pigs that will trample on the treasures of the kingdom. And there are also sheep out there. We need discernment. We need the wisdom from above that is pure and peaceable, gentle, open to reason, full of mercy, good fruits, impartial, and sincere. So this week in your life groups, pray for one another. Seek God and keep seeking God and ask God to give you wisdom. Ask God to give you the grace to have discernment, how to love and how to lead and how to speak truth into people's life. Also, this is a great time. Maybe you just want to pray about some needs. Seek God for your needs. That's Jesus taught us to pray for our daily bread. Keep praying for your daily bread. Keep seeking God. Keep knocking on the door of heaven. And he will give, and he will answer, and he will pour out his blessings, his grace, his truth upon us, because he's a good God. He's a good Father. Well, I hope you're blessed this week, Mountain Church. We'll see you next week. God bless.